This is Jared Horak for TheRunawayHorse.com, and in this week's videos, I'm going to cover two Kentucky Oaks 2021 points races, and then later on, I'm going to post a couple more videos, posting some Kentucky Derby prep race videos. But we're going to concentrate on the Kentucky Oaks prep races for this week for Saturday, January 30th, 2021. We're going to do the Forward Gal from Gulfstream Park and the Martha Washington from Oaklawn Park. We're going to start with, as in post position order, we're going to do the Gulfstream Park race first. So that'll be Gulfstream Park Race 9 for Saturday, January 30th, the Grade 3 Forward Gal Stakes, 3-year-old fillies, 7 furlongs on the main track with a scheduled post time, 3:46 p.m. Eastern Time. And let's jump right into the analysis. Number 1, Hole Bodemeister. This one, 10-1 morning line, 2-for-5 lifetime. So won twice and then didn't come in the other races. The main concern here is the two stake starts. In her two stake starts, she was nowhere to be seen. So now this is going to be her toughest stake start yet. She could show speed from the inside post, but she looks like she's in a tough spot. The two in here, 3 Tipsy Chicks. This one is 5-1 morning line. Ian Wilkes is the trainer. And she improved nicely in all 3 starts last year, including a maiden win at Churchill Downs, 6.5 furlongs on November 21st. She stalked the pace. She won nicely by 2 lengths. So she improved nicely last year. She's got a decent pedigree. Coming off of a layoff, we'll have to see how she ends up doing. She does have a bullet workout for this, and she'll probably be trying to rally from off the pace. The 3, Competitive Speed. This one, probably the one to beat in here, based on those last 3 races, and especially the Glitter Woman last time. But let's go back to her career debut, maiden special weight company. She finished up the track in the slop. Second time out in the slop, maiden claiming 25. She won that one, and then she's been getting better steadily since that race. Then she won an optional claiming race on December 6th, tracking the pace. Then in the Glitter Woman last time, she stalked. She pulled clear. She won by 3 lengths. She's going to stalk the pace in this spot. They have her at 8-1 morning line. I'm sure she's going to be lower than that. She's 2-for-2 at Gulfstream. She's a solid contender in here. The 4, Queen Arella. This one is 20-1 morning line. She's one that looked good in the debut at Gulfstream Park. That was last May. And then 2 stakes races at Saratoga, she was up the track. So she still has to prove herself against stakes company. The 5, Dial to Win, 20-1 morning line. Paco Lopez is going to ride back. She's run well in 2 of 4 starts, and she likes to get up on the pace. She looked good breaking her maiden wire to wire at Gulfstream Park West. But then last time in the Glitter Woman, she was up on the pace, and she was 5th by 10. So she has to prove herself against this kind of company. The 6, Lady Traveler, 4-1 morning line. She did well last year for trainer Dale Romans in her first 3 starts at Churchill Downs. And 6 furlong debut, 3rd by a neck, rallying from off the pace. Second time out, she dueled on the lead, and she broke her maiden at 6 furlongs. 3rd career start, Rags to Riches Stakes. She finished a solid 2nd behind Coach. Then the show finisher was the next out winner there. And then in the Goldenrod Stakes, she was up the track. But the Goldenrod was a tough race. Travel Column, Clairiere, and Coach were 1, 2, 3. Lady Traveler was 8th, beaten 15 lengths. So now she's going to come back in an extended sprint. She's versatile. She's got the ability, as she has moved forward from age 2 to 3, to make a threat, to be a win threat in this spot. Number 7, Zagio for trainer Todd Pletcher. Street Sense is the sire. And this one, 7 furlong debut, Gulfstream Park, December 20th. Nice effort. She didn't break well that day. It was a 10-horse field. She broke from post 3. She broke a bit slow. She had a little bit of early trouble. They were able to get her into a stalking position, and she moved up nicely, took over in the stretch, and won by more than 7 lengths. That was a nice effort. If you get a chance, try to watch that one. I watched it on the Gulfstream Park channel on YouTube. Looked good in that replay. And now coming back, first start against winners, against stakes company, not going to be easy, but she ran well in that race last time, and she's going to need to break a little bit better this time. She doesn't want to make any mistakes against this kind of company. So she can have a nice clean break, track the pace. She's interesting if she improves at all. Finally, number 8, Coach Jair's Joy. This one is 9-2 morning line. Irad Ortiz Jr. is going to ride for trainer Safi Joseph Jr. In the debut in the slop at Gulfstream Park West, she was the favorite. She stalked the pace, pulled clear to win by a couple lengths. I like her tactical speed. I like the outside post. She could be better than the speed figure showed in the slop in the debut. Maybe she's going to be better on fast ground. We're going to find out. So the 8, Coach Jair's Joy, certainly a contender in here. Lady Traveler as well. I think that one can make some noise. Competitive Speed should be right there if she runs back to her Glitter Woman, but I am going to go with the Todd Pletcher trainee, number 7, Azazeel. Has plenty of upside. I'm going to take a chance that she's going to improve, and it's never easy to win the debut at 7 furlongs, but she did just that, and she did it easily. So Azazeel, number 7, my top choice in the forward gal. Let's jump over to Oaklawn Park, and it'll be race 5 for January 30th. The Martha Washington Stakes, $200,000 race, 3-year-old fillies, 1 mile around 2 turns on the main track. And in this race, actually 4:06 p.m. Eastern time is the post time, so it's a little bit after the Gulfstream race. So in this race, number 1, Joy's Rocket is 5-2. Steve Asmussen, she's 4-6 with a second. Her only bad race, and that is a concern, was in the grade 1 Frisette, and that was at 1 mile. That was 1 turn. That was a 1-turn mile. But in that race, she ended up battling on the pace and weakening 4th by 14. Now, that was her longest race, and now she's got to go 2 turns. She's an inside pace factor in here, coming off back-to-back sprint stakes races in those victories, up on the pace both times at Fairgrounds and Keeneland. So she should be part of the pace. The 2, Novel Squall. This one's 15-1 morning line. She's 2-4. She's run well in every other race. Her main problem is the 2 races that she didn't run well were her 2 stake starts, and this is not going to be an easy spot at all. The 3, Coach, your 7-5 morning line favorite for trainer Brad Cox. And this one, she's run well in all of her races. She won her first 3 starts. Her first start was at 6 furlongs at Indiana Grand. Second start, same venue, 5.5 furlongs. She won that one by 9, won the debut by more than 4. Then the Rags to Riches Stakes, by on the 16th at Churchill Downs. She stuck the pace. She won by a couple lengths. And then in the Goldenrod, she was 6-1 in that 9-horse field. She ended up finishing 3rd, stuck the pace, went after the leaders, ended up finishing 3rd, just holding 3rd there. Good effort. Winner, Travel Column, Clairiere was 2nd for Steve Asmussen. Brad Cox trained a Travel Column, so this coaches her stablemate. So I thought the Goldenrod was possibly the best stakes race in the 2-year-old filly ranks last year. And if you read my Kentucky Oaks blog, which I just updated my Kentucky Oaks blog, and you can read that on my Kentucky Derby page at therunawayhorse.com. And if you read my Kentucky Oaks blogs, you'll know that Travel Column and Clairiere are my top 2 rated fillies right now on the road to the Kentucky Oaks. So Coach was 3rd there. I think this is a good spot for her. She's got good tactical speed, and she could certainly win this race. Number 4, Will's Secret for trainer Dallas Stewart. She's 6-1 morning line, and she's one that has typical Dallas Stewart trainee, slowly improving, bred to route, and she's broke the maiden last time in a race originally scheduled for the turf at Fairgrounds, won nicely, rallying from off the pace, from the outside post, racing wide. Good effort. That was her best career effort in 4 starts, and she's now run around 2 turns 3 times. So she has plenty of route experience. She should get pace to chase. The 5, Lady Lily. This one's 9-2 morning line. She's 2-4 with a 3rd. She was 7th by 15 in the Goldenrod, so she was well beaten there. Her other 3 starts were okay, but again, her 2 worst efforts, the Spin Away, she was 3rd by 11, and the Goldenrod, they were her only 2 stake starts. Finally, number 6, Sylvia Q. She hasn't done much wrong. She was 2nd in the debut, setting the pace. A 1 mile turf race at Churchill. 2nd time out, November 28th on the main track, on a fast track at Churchill Downs. She wired the field. Last time in the slop at Fairgrounds, she set the pace. She missed by a nose. They're putting blinkers on, and from that outside post, she's probably going to try to show some speed, but I don't know if she's as quick as Joy's Rocket. So Joy's Rocket probably is the one to catch in this spot. And if you're playing exotics, I think Will's Secret is one that can hit the board in here. But I'm going to go with the 3 Coach for trainer Brad Cox. I just think that she's probably better than these horses. She's got the route experience. She improved her speed figures in all 4 starts last year. I think she exits the best race, the Goldenrod Stakes. She's most likely ready to roll off the layoff. So number 3, Coach, is going to be my top choice in the Martha Washington Stakes. And again, if you're playing exactas, I think you certainly want to use a Will's Secret, number 4, for Dallas Stewart. Maybe spice up the exotics just a bit. So that will wrap up this video. I'm going to be back. I'm going to do the 2 Kentucky Derby points races this week, the Robert Lewis Stakes and the Holy Bull from St. Anita and Gulfstream. So they'll be my next 2 videos. And again, head over to therunawayhorse.com if you're interested in my full cards from St. Anita, my Kentucky Derby and Kentucky Oaks blogs, and free stakes selections from Aqueduct and St. Anita Park as well. You can find all that at therunawayhorse.com. And I'll be back again, like I said, to produce a couple more videos for the road to the Kentucky Derby.